Hello, and welcome. Various situations arise when the loss of coronal tooth structure is so severe that a restoration may not be adequately retained. Today's topic is auxiliary retention with the use of pins.
With direct restorations, there are times when we need additional retention. There are several methods for adding retention.
Vertical walls when parallel or converging offer retention for direct restorations. When the tooth has missing walls as in the picture, the operator has to consider additional retention methods. Additional, supplemental, or auxiliary retention is typically needed if two or more cusps are missing on a molar, or if one cusp is missing on a premolar. To use a pin, 3.5 or 4 mm of preparation depth must be present. 2 mm for the pin and 1.5 or 2 mm for the amalgam depends on whether it is a functional or non-functional cusp.
Methods of retention can be an additional box like a proximal box, a slot or a pot, parapulpal pins, and or adhesives.
The slots, pots and pins are placed within the denon. They are not placed directly on the DEJ. With more adhesive restorations being placed, pins, slots, and pots are not used as often as in the past.
Since vertical walls supply retention, an additional box can be placed. These can be placed on the buccal or lingual. Similar to tongue and groove furniture, the box allows for an interlocking of the materials.
Slots and pots are essentially grooves, small boxes and or cylindrically shaped areas.
When the tooth is vital, a parapulpal pin is an option. Recall that para means beside, adjacent or near, so these pins are adjacent to the pulp. For non-vital teeth, we have another retentive method that is named a post. Pins are parapulpal, and posts are within the pulp space of an endodontically treated tooth.
Now back to vital teeth. When more retention is needed, I ask myself, are all vertical walls retentive? If not, can I converge the non-retentive wall to increased retention? Is there an area where I could place another box? Would a slot or pot retain the restorative material? Is there an area where I can place a parapulpal pin? Do I need a combination of any of these methods? Do I need to use an adhesive restoration?
Of these methods, the parapulpal pin is considered the last resort. If we have another method for retention, we will use the other methods. Why? Parapulpal pins increase retention but decrease resistance form. Also, the placement can be tricky in some teeth when minimal tooth structure remains.
These radiographs show parapulpal pins in anterior teeth. The picture on the left, tooth number 7, shows pins used with composite in an endodontically treated tooth. Today, parapulpal pins are almost never used with adhesive restorations.
Dentistry has used three types of parapulpal pins: cemented, friction retained, and threaded.
With cemented pins, the pin channel diameter is larger than the pin diameter. The pin is retained with a dental cement. The pin is serrated and is about 4 mm in length. 2 mm is within the denon, and 2 mm is within the restorative material.
In friction-retained pins, the pin channel is smaller than the pin. These pins are hammered into the dentin. Friction-retained pins are no longer used as the stress levels created, possibly leading to tooth fracture, are very high.
In the threaded pin, the channel is slightly smaller than the pin. The pin is threaded. No cement is needed. These are also about 4 mm in length. 2 mm of the pin is in denon. 2 mm is in the amalgam.
The least retentive type pin is the cemented pin. The most retentive pin is the threaded pin.
How many pins would we need? One for each missing cusp is the general rule of thumb.
Where should the pin be placed? The line angle of the tooth is usually the best location.
One millimeter inside the DEJ is a safe place for a pin. We want to avoid the pulp and furcations.
Another means of avoiding the pulp and the PDL is to place the pin parallel to the nearest external surface.
We want to avoid the pulp, the DEJ, furcations and the PDL. Study the tooth and the radiograph of the tooth to know where these landmarks are located. Remember the anatomy. Where are the roots? Mandibular molars have two roots, mesial and distal, with two furcations, while maxillary molars have three roots and three furcations.
We need 1 millimeter of space around the pin. This space is to accommodate the amalgam. On the occlusal, that is, above the pin, we need 1.5 to 2 millimeters of amalgam depending on the cusp functional or non-functional. When a pin is placed into a furcation or into the pulp, the tooth has a poor prognosis. If the pin channel enters the pulp, we would place dical and glass ionomer in the pin channel. Then, find another location for a pin.
If the pin channel extends outside the tooth into the PDL, gutta percha root canal filling material is used if below bone level.
Restorative material is used if the perforation is above bone level. Sometimes this part of the tooth fractures and your preparation is now larger than before.
If the pin itself extends into the PDL, consult your periodontist. In all of these situations, inform your patient. Record the information in the chart and record that you informed the patient. After making your pin channel, visually assess the channel. If you see red, it's either in the pulp or the PDL. If you see red at the end of the channel, it is best to not place the pin. The previous slide discusses what the next step will be in this situation. Avoid the situation by placing the pin at a line angle, 1 mm from the DEJ and denon, and parallel to the nearest external surface of the tooth.
Steps for pin placement. 1. Determine the location for your pin. 2. Use a quarter round burr to make a slight dimple. This dimple should be just deep enough to keep the channel former from slipping. Do not make the dimple the full diameter of the burr. 3. Determine your angulation.
Use the periodontal probe or the channel former. Hold the probe or channel former in the gingival sulcus against the external surface of the tooth. Now, move the instrument in towards the pin location and maintain the angulation.
See the drawing. When parallel to the external surface and 1 mm from the DEJ, your pin channel will be located about halfway between the pulp and the external surface. 4. Prepare the channel. Use the slow speed latch handpiece, making sure the handpiece is rotating in a forward direction. Move straight in and straight out of the dentin. Other motions and or additional attempts lead to a pin channel with a large diameter. The pin will not be retained as intended.
In preparing the max pin channel, be sure to prepare the collar space. When the channel former collar reaches the denon, you will feel more resistance. Continue with a little pressure until this collar area is prepared in the denon service.
5. The last step is to place the pin in the channel. The max pin is on a plastic shank, which should shear as soon as the pin is stable in the dentin. Align the pin with the channel and the pin is quickly placed. This is performed using slow speeds and latch handpiece.
The Max pin is a titanium alloy. The twist drill, or channel former, is slightly longer than the pin. The collar produces an inset. The max pin is shorter than the channel and the collar of the pin fits into the collar of the channel. Both of these are advantageous and decrease the stress in the denon. The downside to the max pin is that there are only two sizes. If the channel is too large and you're using a small size pin, you can use the larger size pin. However, if you're using a large pin and the channel is oversized, you will either need to cement the pin or find another location for pin placement.
The collar helps to distribute stresses across the denton. Less stress is created by having the pin shorter than the channel. In most other pin systems, the channel and pin are the same length.
If your channel former does not seem to be working, chances are, the handpiece is rotating backwards. Channel formers do wear out, and if so, it needs to be disposed of in the sharps container.
To summarize pin placement, please review the following steps.
Thank you. Other videos for the interested viewer.